and welcome to this painter video. In this video, we're going to be painting an Ash Waste Nomad up to a parade-ready standard. Now, as you can see here, this miniature is already painted to a battle-ready standard. And if you'd like to see how we did this, you can check it out in a previous video. Now, the first thing we're going to focus on are the brown areas of the miniature. So we're going to layer back up using Fondia Brown, and then we're going to highlight using Talon Sand. So I'm going to take some Fondia Brown here onto my palette, and then thin it down with just some water there. A little bit more water. Roll my brush up to a nice point. And I'm going to apply that as a layer just to brighten up those darker brown areas. We're now going to apply an edge highlight using Talon Sand. Remember to keep your brush up to a nice fine point. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always just tidy back up. With the brown highlighted, we're now going to move on to the green. So for this, we're going to layer up using Castellan Green and then apply an edge highlight of Nurgling Green. So I'm going to take some Castellan Green here onto my palette, thin it down with some water, and then roll my brush back up to a nice point. And I'm going to apply that to the raised areas of the green. And with the layer done, we're now going to highlight using Nurgling Green. I'm just using the edge of my brush to catch the edges there, and I'm using a small layer brush for this. And with that done, the green areas are now complete. So we're going to move on to highlight some of the other areas, and we're going to use White Scar to highlight the cream, Administratum Grey for the black, and then Stormhost Silver on the metallics. So I'm going to take some White Scar here onto my palette, a little bit more, and then just thin it down with some water. And then I'm going to apply that as a highlight onto the cream areas of the model. With the cream done, we're now going to highlight the black areas using Administratum Grey. Next, we're going to use Stormhost Silver as an edge highlight for the metallics. And if you do make any mistakes, you can just tidy them back up. And with that done, the next stages are the eyes and the pipes. So we're going to use Evil Sun Scarlet for the eyes and then apply a spot highlight of White Scar. After that, we're going to use Temple Guard Blue to pick out the blue pipes. So I'm going to take some Evil Sun Scarlet here onto my palette, thin it down with some water, and then I'm going to apply that just onto the eyes of the model. Now we're just going to dot the eye using White Scar. Now we're just going to brighten up those blue pipes using Temple Guard Blue. The next area we're going to focus on is the yellow pipes. So for this, we're going to layer back up using Avalon Sunset and then apply a highlight of Wraithbone. So I'm going to take some Avalon Sunset onto my palette, thin it down with some water. Then I'm going to just layer back up on those yellow pipes just to make them a little bit brighter. Next, I'm just going to highlight that pipe using Wraithbone. And there we are, the yellow pipes are done. Now we're going to move on to the base. So we're going to use Skeleton Horde straight from the pot, and then we're going to apply a dry brush highlight of Wraithbone. So I'm going to take some Skeleton Horde here, just onto my palette, and then I'm going to apply that straight onto the base. There we are with that contrast dry. We're now going to apply a dry brush highlight of Wraithbone. So I'm going to take some Wraithbone here out onto my paper towel and take off as much as I can, just leaving a little bit on the bristles. Then I'm going to apply that all over the base. With that dry brush done, the base is now finished. Now your Ash Waste Nomad Raider is parade ready and now can head out into the deserts of Necromunda. So just a couple of things to remember. When you're highlighting, keep your brush up to a nice fine point, but if you do make any mistakes, you can always just tidy back up after. Also, when you're dry brushing, try to remove as much of the pigment as possible, as this just gives a better end result. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching, and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye bye.